Now, part of completing a project is being able to show somebody what we're actually going to build. And that's where using the AutoCAD sheets comes into play. In this next video, we're going to take everything that we have drawn in model space and make sure that it's laid out correctly in these sheets. So now for our next lesson in Toolbox. Okay, now the next step in this drawing process is going into our sheets and laying out everything inside of our viewports. So going into our cover sheet, you can see here we have our project properties, and this is our title block with different attributes. If we were to update this title block, all the different properties in here will update based off of our project and room properties. Back into project properties, we set up our job description. Inside of room properties, this is all coming in from the data. If you were to right click in this open area and edit room level property, you'll notice here that we have a project wizard variable name base door. So that's how it's picking out what material is being used, the different title blocks that this attribute is on, and of course the title block attribute name. There's another video that you should check out, which is all about adding different room properties and project properties to your drawing, updating the title block, and adding new attributes to your title blocks. So now back into our project tab, we're going to hit the update title block button. Some of those attributes have now updated based on our project properties. Over here, we have our room properties set up in a title block, so those updated too. Now going into the next sheet, which is SH01, we have our plan view with a viewport. Double-clicking inside of that viewport, we can now access model space and line up our drawing. And finally, updating it with the current scale, or the scale that I want to have. So that's 1/2 inch. Let's try, see what 3/4 looks like. And that looks good. It's also the way that we had it drawn in model space. Now that looks good, but unfortunately the dimensions are getting cut off. So let's go back to 1/2 inch scale again, accessing that model space. Now at this point, there's a few things that we need to do with some of the objects inside of this drawing. So lock this viewport, and now we can still work inside of our sheet, but we're in model space. Because we're in this 1/2 inch scale now, and that's not how the 2D drawings were drawn originally, we have our item numbers that aren't lining up. But that's all right. I don't want to show my item numbers anyway on these set of shop drawings. We're going to wait till we send it off to production to do that. And also, you might not want to show it in the plan view anyway. So what we can do here is use our lay freeze shortcut and freeze that layer. Remember, we also wanted to hide that finished end text. So let's select that layer, and that's our zero layer that just got hidden. Now you will notice that the dimensions that are coming in from the product have updated with the correct scale, but the ones that I added myself through AutoCAD are not. One way we can do this is by just selecting those. Those are the dimensions that I added. Right click, and because this was only drawn with the current annotative scale, which was 3/4, I need to add this new scale. So now I'm going to add the current scale, which is 1/2 inch. I have it set up the way that I prefer, which is not adding all the scales to every object that I add to my drawing, but you can set it up however you like. Okay, now that we have everything updated with the correct scale, I'm going to double click outside of the viewport again, and now we're working back in paper space. So I want to show a little trick that I like to do. Just get that plan view label out of the way. We'll keep that there in paper space, but for this call out pointing out the elevations, I'm going to show you a little trick. So remember, we currently are in paper space with this object. I'm going to type in CH space, which is short for change space. Select my object, right click or enter, and now it's pushed that object from paper space into model space. You can see here we have our viewport highlighted, letting you know we're back into model space. Double click outside again. You also can change from paper space to model space by using the AutoCAD status bar. So that'll tell you what space you're in. Back to model. And now you can see here, we have that call out pointing out our elevation. I just use our AutoCAD copy command, because this is a drawing block, a dynamic drawing block that we have set up in Toolbox. And rotate that arrow. And also type in ET to edit the text. Elevation A, maybe change the sheet number, and we can do the same to the next one. Back into our sheets, SH01, that looks good. Now for our elevation drawing. So we only have one viewport, so first off, let's give ourselves 2. Find somewhere in the center, you can snap to the center point if you can find it. There it is. Now just an AutoCAD copy command, copy that viewport over, snap to the midpoint, and move our paper space elevation label over. Again, updating it to match what you have on your shop drawing, so there's no inconsistencies. And then once you get your elevation into your viewport, change your scale again. We'll have to just double check to make sure that it's all coming in correctly at the half inch scale. We may need to redraw just this 2D wall. Now we have that elevation label that's coming in from our product itself in model space. I want to hide this layer, but because there's a couple other objects on this drawing that share that layer, we're going to have to go in and change those first. So this is our text with multi-liter and that rectangle representing our sink. So let's select those objects. Right click and show properties, and here we can change that layer. 2D text would probably be a better layer for that. So now when we do our lay freeze, it's only freezing it in this current viewport, selecting that object, and that looks a lot better. Now let's redraw our 2D walls so we can get our finished labels to line up. They've shifted slightly on the right hand side. Now we can bring over the section call out and find a place to put that. We'll give them a section of our sink cabinet with the upper above. Now elevation B, let's do the same thing. Bring it into our drawing, changing our scale. And once I have it positioned, I like to lock the viewport. So lock that viewport, and we can now do our lay freeze again, turn that off. Again, redraw the 2D walls if text needs to get realigned. But we can get to the end of this exercise by finishing up these shop drawings. So again, we're just copying that section call out using our edit text in AutoCAD to edit the attributes. So I didn't even catch this until I was printing out the drawings in one of our other videos for this job. But I accidentally hid this non-ADA sync text. So rather than just letting it go, I figured I'd jump back in and make that correction. Real simple, just changing back the layer. So my fault. All right, let's get this done quick. So yeah, if this happens to you, just get back into that viewport. It is locked, so you can zoom in and kind of see what's going on. Open up those list of layers and thaw that zero layer. All right, so now we got that zero layer thawed. We can work with this text again. Right click, show properties, and change that to a 2D text. I'll do lay freeze again. Now that looks a lot better. Now let's set up our detail page. We'll give ourselves a couple different areas to work in here. So there's our first viewport, second, and third. Now the lines from the viewport are hidden. One way you can tell is by going to the top. I have a plot preview button that I've set up. So you can see there, we got nothing showing up. The viewport lines are hidden. Another way that you can verify that is into your layer state manager and finding our viewport layer. Let's expand our window so we can see this a little bit easier. So that's our layers to be plotted or printed with that negative symbol. Means it will not print. And now the sheet can be used for our cross-section drawings. That'll be included in our next video where we continue to work with our 2D drawing tools and add those additional cross-sections with details to this new kitchen project. So that brings us to a good stopping point. We'll call this one done for now and we'll pick it back up in our next video. So until next time, keep practicing and we'll meet back here for some more training.